Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum and good morning to all my charming students of class 5. Today we are back in the science class with another lecture. So guys, I want everyone to be ready for the written work. So let's get started. First, you need to maintain your indices. You need to make the title page. On title page, you'll simply write the name of the chapter and you will write reasons in name these. No question answers we are having, no diagrams, just reasons and name these. So first you need to maintain your indices. You will write the date properly. You will just write the name of the chapter with your blue color. Then you will write reasons and name these. Okay, then you will get the sign of your parents. When your copy would be submitted to school, your teacher's sign column would also be utilized by your teacher, right? So let's go ahead. I hope everyone is with me because I gave you this homework to copy down reasons and name these. So here comes the reason number one. Most of the accidents happen when we are not careful. Most of the accidents happen when we are not careful. So we need to write, yes, I want everyone to write with me. I want all the students to write the answers with me. Okay, Malahim, no issue if your half reasons are in copy one and rest of the reasons are in copy two. But beta, you should have utilized copy two. If you know that you are not having enough pages to complete your reasons and name this, you should have started your work in copy two. But if you have started, so it's okay. You can just submit your both copies when it will be asked by school, right? So students, write with me. Write with me. Yes, we should be careful from fire, sharp knife, and electrical appliances. Yes, we should be careful from fire, sharp knife, and electrical appliances. Amna, what do you need to ask? Ask me in the chat box. Answer of reason number one is, yes, we should be careful from fire, sharp knife, and electrical appliances. Should we go to the next reason? I want everyone to write fast so we can complete it today's class, because from next class we'll be having revision. So let's go to the reason number two. Reason number two is, medicines should be kept out of reach of children. Medicines should be kept out of reach of children. So the answer is going to be yes. The answer is going to be yes. Okay, beta, you should know the answer in your words as well, okay? If I ask you to answer me such reasons, so you can answer me in your own words, you can say that, yes, medicine should definitely be kept out of reach of children, because if they take it in excess amount, of course, they can die. They can die. They can get different things. Like, you can say that their condition can even be worse, right? So the answer is, Yes, because it can be dangerous to them. Yes, because it can be dangerous to them if taken in excess amount. If taken in excess amount. Yes, it can be dangerous to them if taken in excess amount. Now we are going to the next one. The next one comes in front of you now. The plastic covering over an electrical wire is only for decoration. It does not have any other use. Is it so? No, we know that First of all, don't write. I'm just telling you in my own words that the plastic covering on electrical wire are not only for decoration. Yes, we can change their colors for the decoration. We can change their covering. But the reason that we have covered them is that it is for protection. Because naked wires are very dangerous to us because it has the current. So if one touches the naked wire, he or she can get electrocution. Means current. Okay, so here comes the answer in front of you. That is your reason number C. It means reason number three. Those students who have entered now in the class, Aman Khurram, you just joined us right now. So we are doing our reasons and name these. Now we are on reason number three. So leave two reasons and start writing the answer from reason number three. Lecture would be available for you. You can complete your incomplete work afterwards. So, beta, the answer is no comma. Okay, I'm not going to say comma, okay? You need to write yourself. No, electrical wires are covered for safety purpose. No, electrical wires are covered for safety purpose. No, electrical wires are covered for safety purpose. Now I'm going to the next one. Here comes your fourth reason, or reason number D. We have given the bit numbers as A, B, C, D according to our book. So here comes the reason number D. That is, you should switch on the exhaust fan if there is a leak in the gas cylinder in your home. You should switch on the exhaust fan if there is a leak in the gas cylinder in your home. So definitely it's going to be yes, it's going to be true, it's going to be tick, not the cross. Why? Because we know if we feel the smell of gas, or we just feel that it is leaked from somewhere, right? So we need to open the doors and windows plus exhaust fan. Why? Because exhaust fan just takes out the, like we can say, suffocation or the gases in the room. It takes out of the room. It takes all the gases and suffocation out of the room or out of the kitchen. So it is a good way to switch on this exhaust fan if there is a leak of gas. So you're going to write in the words, yes, it allows the gas. Yes, it allows the gas. Yes, it allows the gas to escape outside. Yes, it allows the gas to escape outside from house because it is dangerous. But when I just read the reason, the statement of the reason, so I explain in my own words, okay? So the sentences which I am using for explaining you, please don't write those sentences in your copy. That is not your dictation, right? You will be shown the actual answer after a bit explanation, right? So answer is yes, comma, it allows the gas to escape outside from the house because it is dangerous. The next one comes here in front of you. Nylon cloth should be worn while cooking. No. When we are reading our book, we underline this line as well, that nylon cloths can catch the fire easily. So definitely we should not wear it while cooking. So your statement is, nylon cloths should be worn while cooking. It is going to be cross or wrong or false. So the answer is no. Nylon can catch the fire easily. No. Nylon can catch the fire easily. No. Nylon can catch the fire easily. No, Now here comes the next one. To put out a fire, we should try to cut off its air supply. Yes. If you remember when we were reading the book, I asked you to underline a very important line. Fire needs air to keep burning. Fire needs air to keep burning. So if there's a fire, we should cut off the air supply first. If there would be no air supply, the fire would be just extinguished itself as well. So the answer is yes. Yes, because air helps the fire to keep burning. Yes, because air helps the fire to keep burning. Air helps the fire to keep burning. Yes, air helps the fire to keep burning. Here comes the next one in front of you. A petrol fire should be put out by pouring water over it. I told you that all the fire cannot be extinguished by pouring water, such as petrol fire or the fire caused by electricity or kerosene. Right? So there are some of the reasons of the fire on which we can not use water, and petrol fire is one of them. So it is going to be no. Petrol is lighter than water. Therefore water cannot stop fire. No, petrol is lighter than water, therefore water cannot stop fire. Therefore, water cannot stop fire. Now here comes the next one in front of you. A burn should be immediately treated with warm water. The person who is burning already, the person who has got burned, he should be treated with warm water. The burning is itself warm, and if we utilize the warm water, how the person will cool down, how the blisters will cool down, how the skin of the person will cool down. So definitely it is going to be wrong. Burn can never be burn. I'm talking about burn, not any injury, right? I'm not talking about all the injuries, but the burn. Burn should be immediately treated with warm water. No, it should be treated with cold water to prevent blisters. Blisters are not formed when our skin cools down. And if we pour warm water, so warm water would not allow your skin to cool down. So the answer is no, it should be. Yes, Ali, very good. Ali, you're responding me in the chat box, but if I ask you to unmute yourself, you do not do. So the answer is no, it should be treated with cold water to prevent blisters. I told you about blisters. Like that we call it in Urdu as pani wale chhale that are caused by the burn. No, it should be treated. It should be treated with cold water to prevent blisters. I don't know what do we call blisters in Urdu, so just that is why I just use that word. I hope you have understood. Okay, so let's go to the next reason. Shehbaz, you have joined us right now. Beta, we are doing our reasons in Name This today. Take out your copy one or two if one is filled and continue the work. Okay, beta, reason, the bit I, an infected wound should be treated with warm water. Here we are talking about infected wound. There we were talking about the burn. Burn can never be treated with warm water because the person needs to cool down. But here comes the infected wound. An infected wound should be treated with warm water. Yes. Hafsa, beta, we are having the limited time. That is why I'm just going ahead. I am not going to show any of the slide. Lecture would be available for you. Or if we get the time in the last, I'll show all the reasons to you again. Okay. So first, please, beta, let me complete the reasons and name these so we can successfully start our revision from the next class. An infected wound should be treated with water, should be treated with warm water. Here we are saying yes. Why we are saying yes? Because you know that why do we boil the water? Of course, we boil the water to kill the germs. So if the water or anything comes warmer or becomes warmer, it can kill the germs. So likewise, we can use the warm water for different wounds, but not for the burn. Okay. In burn, we need to give the cold water or we need to treat with cold water. So the answer is yes, because warm water can kill the germs. Yes, because warm water can kill the germs. 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 Here comes the next one. If someone fractures a leg, doing light exercises of the leg will help in healing the fracture. When we talk about the bone, we know that we get fracture in the bones, not in the muscles. Our muscles can be damaged. Our tissues of the muscles can be damaged. But when it comes on bone, we use the word broken or fractures. So if in the case of bone, if the bone is fractured or broken, person is not recommended for even lighter exercise it at all. The person is recommended not to move the infected area or broken bone or fractured bone. So your reason is, if someone fractures a leg, doing light exercises of the leg will help in healing the fracture? No, it will increase the pain. It will increase the pain. Taha, very nice. We should go to the doctor. But when we go to the doctor recommends us some of the things. So remember one thing. First of all, what do? We just do experiments with patient. We do experiments ourselves, right? And so this is not good at all. In the case of fractured bone or broken bone, of course, we need to go to the doctor. But remember one thing, doctor doesn't recommend you to move your bone which is fractured, because it can only increase the pain. It will not heal your bone. So go to the next one. Now here comes the name these. I hope that students have copied down. Yes, Alina, doctor gives medicine. Very good. Doctor gives medicine that will heal the bone. That is also good. But the person is usually asked for the rest. Okay, Taha. Nice word. Okay, class. So I hope that you have copied down name these. Will not be taking much time in name these, because I expect from you guys that you have already copied down. If you just write the answers, it will not take time, okay? So the name these, number one is two liquid fuels whose fire cannot be put out using water, as they are lighter than water. We just talked in reasons as well. I told you that all the fire cannot be extinguished by pouring water. So there are the names of two fuels. Names of two fuels whose fire cannot be put off using water. Very good, Hamna. Well done. Yes, the answer is petrol and kerosene. These are two liquid fuels. We are much more familiar with petrol, but many of the students might not know about the kerosene. You need to remember that these are two liquid fuels. If the fire is caused by these two reasons, we cannot utilize water to extinguish that fire because there would be no change. Why there would be no change? Water is not going to affect the fire because it is lighter than the water. So water cannot fight with it. Name these. Number two comes here in front of you. You should throw this over an electrical fire to put out the fire. You should throw this over an electrical fire to put out the fire. If you remember, we discussed that in petrol, kerosene, and electrical fire, we cannot use water. So if there is an electrical fire, instead of water, what we can use? Yes, Hamna, very good. We can use sand. So the answer of name these number two is sand. Answer is sand. Okay, Alina, we can also write the fire extinguisher, but here we cannot write. Why? Because see how the question is asked. Your question is asked, what you will put? Aap kya rakhenge us cheez par? Aap aisa us par kya rakhenge jisse wo aag jo hai bujh jaye? Right? So if you will see the wording properly, you will come to know that here we cannot write fire extinguisher. We are going to write sand. Because we can put the sand on the fire caused by electricity or electrical gadget or electrical fire. Now here comes the next one. Device used to put out the fire. Yes, now we can write that answer which Alina told me right now. Yes, fire extinguisher is a device. So when you are being asked that name the device which is used to put out the fire, so that would be fire extinguisher. But there in reason number in name these number two, we just particularly talked about electrical fire. Okay, so we should know that particularly in electrical fire, in petrol, in kerosene, in these cases we do not use water. In electrical fire, we can put the sand, but the device which can be used is named as fire extinguisher. The next one is in front of you. This is really easy. I want students to answer me in the chat box. Care given to an injured person before arrival of a doctor or nurse. Aliza beta, what do you want to say? Tell me in the chat box because we are having limited time. So that is why right now I'm not gonna unmute anyone. So if you have any query, you can ask me in the chat box. Yes, Taha, you have given the right answer. Hafsa, you have given right answer. I want more number of students to answer me. To put cold water on it? No. We do not know what kind of injury it is. That depends on the injury, that how we are going to treat it. So all the things are includingly called as first add, that is the name of your chapter as well. I told you in the beginning, we will not wrap a blanket. Yes, first wrapping a blanket can be the first add. In which situation? When a person gets when the clothes of a person gets fire, So that would be first step. Okay, but we do not know that what kind of injury it is. So the common word which you are going to use is first aid, okay? Because this word can be used for the fire, for different injuries, even for rabies, even for tetanus. Whatever the injury is, whatever the situation is, the very first care given to the injured person or the infected person before the doctor is first aid, right? Let's go ahead. Now here comes the next one in front of you. Yes. That is blisters. Many of the students have told me the answer. Small bubble-like swellings that form on the skin when it gets burned. Yes, very good. Blisters. These are called as blisters. I hope the students are writing the answers with blue color. Their statement of the name, these should be done with pencil. Their answers would be done with blue color. Yes, so small bubble-like swelling that form on the skin when it gets burned, blisters. Now here comes the next one, a medicine applied to a wound to prevent it from getting infected. A medicine applied to a wound to prevent it from getting infected. So, yes, Malahim, yes, you are right, but we are not going to write it directly. Okay, Malahim has told me Dettol and Taha Singh bandage. Okay, so you are giving me the answers according to your concept, and I am glad to see that at least you are trying and you are somewhere near the answer. So I'm going to disclose the answer. The answer is antiseptic. Antiseptic, Dettol can be antiseptic, but rather than other than Dettol, we are having different antiseptic. There is a liquid, a brown color liquid that we just pour on the infected area or the wound before wrapping it with bandage. What does it call?
Pyodine.
Yes, we use pyodine as well. That is also, yes. Rich, you're right. Yes, pyodine, yes. Very nice. So these kind of solutions are called as antiseptic. Remember this, that if you just answer me while writing the Dettol, so that would be wrong. If it comes in your examination and you write the Dettol, that would be that would not be completely right. So that is why I'm not going to give the marks in such case. If you have been asked medicine applied to a wound from getting infected, to prevent from getting infected, would be antiseptic. Pyodine can be antiseptic. If I ask you to give me the reasons of antiseptic, so you can tell me the pyodine and Dettol and other as well, right? So answer is going to be antiseptic. Now here comes the next one. Deep dirty wounds can cause this dangerous disease. Deep dirty wounds that we usually get when we just fall down on the roads. Yes, very good. That is tetanus. In such case, we get the injection, we go to the doctor recommends us this injection. Okay, this is tetanus. Now here comes the next one. That is really easy. This is very easy, guys. A disease which can be caused by the dog bite. This is very easy. Yes, very good. Very good, everyone. Very good, Hamna, Hafsa. Very good, Amna. Very good. Yes, the answer is rabies. Rabies is a disease caused by the dog bite or the monkey bite or different animals, but especially the dog bite, okay? Let's go to the next one. A twisted joint that swells up A twisted joint that swells up is very painful. What is this condition called? In case of bone, we say that fractured bone or broken bone. But when it comes on the swelling of joints, we use a kind of word that I told you as well. Yes, very good. Yes, Hafsa, you're right. So the answer is sprain. That is called as sprain. That is sprain. Okay, when it comes about the joint or swelling up of joints, like we also called it as jodon ki sujan. So that is called as sprain. So this was all about the reasons and name these, okay? And I hope that all the students have done it. I want this work to be completed today. I hope many of the students have completed their work. Now we are having less than 1 minute. I want to see your copy, whether you have done it or not. Whether you have done it or not. I want to see your copy. Yes, very good, Hamna. Bring your copy closer to the camera and show me if you have done. Very good, Hamna. Okay, Hamna, I've seen your work. Good. Hafsa, okay, very good. Very nice. Yes, Iraj, I have seen. Very good. Okay, Alina, no problem. If your camera is not working, beta, try to get online with the gadget which is having camera from the next class, okay? Okay, Malahim, I've seen your work.